you don't have difficulties passing urine, you may still have prostate cancer. That's why the PSA, which is a specific protein produced by the prostate gland, if it goes up, that's when you need to know, and it's better. By the time you have the prostate being enlarged, you can actually use a scan, ultrasound scan, to determine the size of prostate gland, or you can actually put a finger in the rectum of the man, and you can actually palpate it, and you see that the prostate gland is enlarged. And you can almost know if it's enlarged, you see it being very hard and irregular. It can suggest to you that that's prostate gland. But again, the growth takes a long time to develop. So if after the age of 40, one of the tests that annual tests that a man must take is PSA. It's not very expensive. Less than 5,000 naira to do that test. Then passive smoking, cigarette smoking, is as deadly as active smoking. That's as they settled. So if I do, I don't sit near anybody who smokes. And I don't go, that's why if you go outside the country anywhere, there's a procession in the airplane, they say, in fact, those days, they used to have sessions in the airplane, but these days, no airplane allows smoking. I don't know of any airplane that allows smoking. But if you go to the airport lounge, you will see a park, a place, they will lock it up completely. If you're a smoker, you can go and smoke there. But most countries have regulations against smoking, because we found out that passive smoking is as deadly as active smoking. Now, somebody asked a question as to whether sucking the breast can affect, increases the likelihood of having breast cancer. The answer is, I'm not aware. They are sucking the breast. As a matter of fact, sucking the breast, as a gynecologist, we recommend it for women because it produces a fatty hormone that helps to moderate a lot of things in women and also to improve their mindset. So both for children and for men, there's nothing harm in doing breast sucking. It doesn't cause cancer. And it increases the bond of relationship. So be it. You're allowed to do it. Then the cancer, after whether the cancer is infectious, again, there's no evidence that cancer is infectious. Even though cancer of the cervix is said to be due to human papilloma virus, there's also cancer of the penis, which is likely due to cancer of the human papilloma virus. The penis, the scrotum, all of those areas, the testes, there are signs for cancers, but there is no evidence to date that any of the cancers that are listed are infectious, or you can transfer it from person to person. So, and I've been a gynecologist, I've managed a lot of cases of cancer service. I've not seen a man being infected and having cancer as a result of having sex with his husband who has cancer service. So, cancer is not an infection. Then the last question is why taller men are greater risk? Because taller men have more sex. They are bigger, they have more cells. And if you have more cells, then there are higher chances that one of them can become cancerous, can become abnormal. If you are small and short, you have fewer cells, and therefore the risk of developing cancer will also be small, just of your size. So I think that's the answer to that. Thank you very much.